गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल।
वेलकम टू क्लास 12th इकोनॉमिक्स पीरियड।
सो बिफोर वी स्टार्ट द क्लास, यू ऑल नो व्हाट वी नीड टू डू। मेडिटेशन टू रिलैक्स योरसेल्फ, है ना? सो लेट्स स्टार्ट दैट। सो प्लीज बी इन ज्ञान मुद्रा एवरीवन एंड डू द मेडिटेशन फॉर 2 मिनट्स and then we'll continue the topic. Okay, so I think all of you are relaxed, right? Meditation is also over. So first of all, you all know that we have, you know, a reduction in syllabus done by CBSE released yesterday, right? And if I talk about that reduction, particularly in economics, then I must say that that reduction is not that satisfactory for economics, because all the topics are still there. If they have deleted from one chapter, but that topic is there in the other chapter. For example, if I talk about the credit control by central bank, remember now we have covered that. We have covered credit control by central bank in budget, in money and banking. You know, the same topic is there in, the same topic is there in other unit also. So they have deleted that topic from money banking, but we have the same topic in the other chapter. So we have to do that, and we have already covered already. So these are the topics which have been deleted by the CBSE in 12th economics. If you look at unit 2, money and banking, they are saying the topics deleted are control of credit through bank rate, CRR, SLR, repo rate, reverse repo rate, open market operations, margin requirements, which means that you need not to study that how central bank controls credit through these quantitative and qualitative measures. They have deleted this topic from this chapter. But the same topic we have in the unit determination of income and employment where we will learn that how we have to control the inflationary gap. So the same topic we will be covering there, hai na? So we don't have to do that topic from this chapter, but no doubt we have to do the topic in the other chapter. So that is almost same. कुछ नहीं हटा इसमें से, ठीक है? चलो next चलते हैं. Unit 5, balance of payment. Balance of payment deficit. The meaning is removed for balance of payment deficit. Meaning was just hardly of two lines. They have removed that balance of payment deficit. So we need not to do the balance of payment deficit. That we'll be covering in the chapter when we'll start it. And they have removed determination of exchange rate in a free market. Diagram based question they have removed. Okay, all right. If we talk about Indian economic development, nothing have been deleted from Indian economic development. Only and only in unit 7, current challenges facing Indian economy, they have just deleted one topic from one chapter. Infrastructure, they have deleted energy topic, and they have deleted organic farming topic. That's it. So these are the topics which have been deleted by CBSE. But theek hai, agar economics to is of course a very important subject. Aaj ke time pe to you all know that economics has a greater importance, hai na? Eco mein, economics mein, theek hai, unhone delete nahin kiya. I think it's okay, it's fine if they haven't deleted anything. Because if they could have deleted everything, to kya left reh jata to study, hai na? Fir hum log padhte kya? So it's okay if they haven't deleted anything. We are still okay. We are still fine. We will work hard. So kya hoga if we are online, if we are studying online, but study to study, hai na? So no problem at all. Chik? So let's continue with the topic that we were doing, agriculture. Yes. So we were doing the topic agriculture from the period 1950 to 1990, right? Now, first of all, again, let me tell you once again that agriculture we are studying because it's an important aspect, and India took various steps from 1950 to 1990 to improve agriculture in India, right? But before studying or before directly going to what steps, what policies government made in agriculture during that particular period, we have to study that what are the features of Indian agriculture. Features of Indian agriculture means what are the characteristics? What are the characteristics, features, or problems? Even we'll study the problems. That what problems were there in Indian agriculture on the eve of independence that we had to go for making policies in our planning system for the time period 1950 to 1990. So definitely we have to study first that what are the problems involved in Indian agriculture. If you remember the period on the eve of independence, there I told you that agriculture sector on the eve of independence, I explained there that agriculture sector was very, very outdated, backward, right? Can anybody tell me that what were the conditions of agriculture at that time? What was the condition? Why agriculture sector was not good at that time? That we had to make a plan ki bhai agriculture ko to theek karna padega. Jiske liye we took some serious steps during this planning system from 1950 to 1990 to improve the stage of agriculture, to improve the condition of Indian agriculture. Just raise your hands, please. Can anybody tell me that what was the condition of Indian agriculture during that time? Please raise your hands. Okay. Anmol. Yes, Anmol.
Sir, actually in India, agriculture more than 70% of population is मतलब 70% से भी ज्यादा population लगी हुई थी. Yes. सर बट मतलब इंडिया लेकिन तब भी सेल्फ मतलब सफिशिएंट नहीं था, उसको तब भी फॉरेन से लेना पड़ता था सामान. तो सर एक तो ये था कि इसलिए हमें मतलब एग्रीकल्चर को हमें डेवलप करने की जरूरत पड़ी ताकि हमारे लोग अब मतलब इंडिया में ही खा सकें.
ओके व्हाट एल्स?
और सर
वेट वरुण भाटिया. यस वरुण वांट्स टू एक्सप्लेन. यस वरुण. वरुण योर वॉइस इज नॉट क्लियर.
सर तब बहुत ज्यादा डिपेंडेंस होता था रेनफॉल में जिसकी वजह से.
यस ओके ठीक है वरुण. ओके सक्षम. यस सक्षम.
सर मोस्ट ऑफ द फार्मर्स वर डिपेंड ऑन द रेनफॉल. देयर इज लो प्रोडक्टिविटी and small and fragmented land holdings and tariff and zamindari systems and British exploitation, forced commercialization and some
other agriculture. Okay, fine. So ultimately we had already studied that there were a lot of problems which we were facing in Indian agriculture. Suppose the five I just said that you people are the leading politicians of the country. And India ko abhi independence mili. Suppose this is the time of 1947. India got independence and 3 years it took to finalize that what type of economy you want to have. You finalize that we want to have the mixed economy. Now, very first point was the when the planning commission was made, very first point in your mind would definitely come that what things are there ready on which we need to make a plan, right? What things are there on which we need to make a plan? So you will definitely think of that. And what they did and what you as a leader will do, definitely you will take care of agriculture first. Because when you see that almost 75% of working population was just dependent on agriculture only. And 75% of the working population was dependent on agriculture only. Then definitely you need to improvise the agriculture. That's why when the planning commission started, making the plans for the economy, very first thing which planning commission did was improvising the agriculture. That agriculture must be improvised. Agriculture must be improved. All right. So now, features of Indian agriculture at that time, that jiski wajah se hum logo ko laga that we need to do something for the agriculture. See, we were facing that our productivity was highly dependent on rainfall. We have already studied this point. This mein humne padha tha, high degree of vulnerability, right? High degree of vulnerability means high dependence on rainfall. So it was basically observed that Indian agriculture was highly dependent on rainfall. Indian agriculture was highly dependent on rainfall. Why it was highly dependent on rainfall? It was highly dependent on rainfall because we were not having good irrigation facilities with us. And when we were not having good irrigation facilities with us, then definitely a good rainfall in a year means good productivity. And a bad rainfall in a year means bad productivity. That thing was observed. Pani ke liye we didn't have much irrigation facilities. We were not at all developed and we were not knowing the various methods of irrigation, right? We could opt. Definitely in that case, we were completely dependent on the rainfall only for the irrigation. As a result, in a year, there comes the good rainfall, that means there would be the good productivity, good production. And if there is less rainfall, bad rainfall, no rainfall, which means there would be no productivity, less productivity or bad productivity. So that was the one of the major problem that we were facing in Indian agriculture. If I talk about the second one, there was little use of machinery, right? There was little use of machinery. Yes, we were not using the machineries. यू नो दैट टाइम आपने देखा भी है पुरानी मूवीज में, सब में देखा है, मदर इंडिया में देखा है, लगान में देखा है, वी वर नॉट यूजिंग द गुड मशीनरी सिस्टम बिफोर इंडिपेंडेंस. We were using the cows or buffaloes for the cultivation of the crops. Instead, now we have started using the tractors, we have started using the cultivators or threshers. But that time we were not using all these things at all. We were just into using the cows or buffaloes for the cultivation of the entire land area, which was very difficult, right? So ultimately, because of these non-mechanical inputs we were applying into the agriculture, our productivity was not up to the mark jitni honi chahiye thi. I hope this problem is also clear to all. Now if I talk about the third problem, production mainly for self-consumption. Production mainly for self-consumption. You know, we were mainly into the production for self-consumption only. प्रोडक्शन दो चीज के लिए प्रोडक्शन होती है. वन इज फॉर द सेल्फ कंजम्पशन एंड द अदर इज फॉर द सरप्लस, मार्केटेबल सरप्लस. मार्केटेबल सरप्लस मींस व्हेन यू आर सेलिंग योर क्रॉप्स इन द मार्केट, व्हेन यू आर सेलिंग योर क्रॉप्स इन द मार्केट एंड यू आर जनरेटिंग इनकम एंड यू आर गेटिंग इनकम, दैट इज नोन एज marketable surplus. And one is subsistence farming. Subsistence farming means you are producing for yourself only. You are not going to sell that crops into the market. So it was observed that people were taking agriculture output only for their subsistence farming. Yes, people were taking agriculture only for their subsistence farming. And for their subsistence farming means that they people just were doing the agriculture activities so that they can grow crops for themselves and they can consume all those crops and earn their livelihood only from the cropping. सपोज मैंने वीट उगा लिया, किसी मेरे फ्रेंड ने, मेरे फ्रेंड फार्मर ने किसी ने राइस ग्रो कर लिया, मेरे एक और फ्रेंड फार्मर ने शुगर केन ग्रो कर लिया, एंड वी एक्सचेंज्ड द प्रोडक्ट्स एज इन द बार्टर सिस्टम एंड दे वर नॉट अर्निंग द मार्केटेबल सरप्लस. मार्केटेबल सरप्लस, सरप्लस यू ऑल नो, सरप्लस मीन्स प्रॉफिट. मार्केटेबल सरप्लस मीन्स द प्रॉफिट विच यू हैव अर्नड फ्रॉम द मार्केट. सो वी वर नॉट हैविंग द मार्केटेबल सरप्लस इन एग्रीकल्चर ड्यूरिंग दैट टाइम before independence, on the eve of independence. Why? Because we were more into the subsistence farming. Farming karo, jo bhi production ho, consume that production yourself, right? So that was a major problem because itne bade bade crops aap grow kar rahe ho and you are not selling that into the market. Agar aap, if you sell that into the market, you definitely earn a lot of money from that, but you are not earning because you are not selling that into the market. So definitely we should do something like that. That's why in planning system from 1950 onwards, the government introduced various markets in the fields of agriculture. We will study further. Government introduced various markets in the field of agriculture where people, where farmers could definitely go to the, you know, those markets and could sell their crops wo crops vagara sell kar sakte the, right? I hope I'm clear. Next point dekhiye. Acha, don't you think there was disguised unemployment due to the agriculture? What is disguised unemployment? You all know already. Who will tell me what is disguised unemployment? Kindly raise your hand, please. Who will tell me what is disguised unemployment? Yes, Vaibhav.
Sir, disguised unemployment in which people are seems to be working, but they are not working. For example, five workers are working on a land, but only two workers are needed. Rest three are of disguised unemployment.
Very good. So disguised unemployment means when we simply say that in a market, in a production unit, we require only 10 people for the working in that production unit. But what we observe is more than 10 people are working in that production unit. More than 10 people are working in that production unit. Definitely suppose if 5 more are working, then the extra 5 would be termed as disguisedly unemployed. Means they seems like they people are working. It seems like they people are working and they are employed. But the reality is, agar wo nahi bhi hote, there would not be any problem in that production unit. Because unke aane se, there is no more extra production which we are doing. That's why the extra persons who are employed there are known as disguisedly unemployed. All right? So it was observed in agriculture that people are disguisedly unemployed, a major problem. Because if in a field there is requirement of only 4 persons to work, the whole family is working on the same field only. The whole family is working on the same field only. So the extra people would be termed as disguisedly unemployed. So ultimately, disguised unemployment takes place into the situation in agriculture. Okay. So I have told you that there was the problem like disguised unemployment, the problem like high dependency on rainfall, and definitely the problem of subsistence farming, which means production mainly for self-consumption, and outdated technology. The next problem which we were facing in Indian agriculture, outdated technology. As I told you that we were using very small amount of machinery. Little use of machinery was there. Even some farmers in the poor states like Bihar, Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, they were not even using the machinery at all. Wo kuch bhi machinery they were not using. Right? Wo log bilkul everything they were doing just with themselves only. Wo pura ka pura sab kuch hi khud karte the, or they were taking the help of animals. Otherwise, they were not doing anything with the use of machinery. Even the seeds which they were using were not, you know, of high yield variety. They were not using the high yield variety seeds, HYV seeds. They were using the cow dung, or they were using the other conventional methods of techniques only, which now should be changed. And if I tell you about the other problems, then I can say that there was conflict between tenant and landlords. Okay, you tell me, what do we call to this point? There is one word which is being given to this point. Conflicts between tenant and landlords. Kindly mention in the chat box which was the point which was there, which was the point which belongs to this. I got the answer from Gurnoor. Others also, please write the answer. Very good, Saksham. Vaibhav. Okay. Others also, please take initiative. Priyanshi, Anmol. Others, Toshit. Zamidari system, very good. So Zamidari system is actually the system which was prevailing in India. And don't you think after independence, there was a time to actually demolish the Zamidari system? There was a time actually to remove the Zamidari system from India? Agreed or not? Agar aap leader hote, तो आप ये करते या ना करते? दिव्य सिंह, यस सर, ऑफ कोर्स, बिल्कुल हम यही करते. वेरी गुड. बिकॉज जमींदारी सिस्टम वॉज प्रिवेलिंग इन इंडियन इकोनॉमी एंड दैट वॉज टू बैड. हु विल एक्सप्लेन मी जमींदारी सिस्टम? रेज योर हैंड्स प्लीज. हु इज गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन मी जमींदारी सिस्टम? और आई शुड आस्क फ्रॉम यू पीपल. गुरनूर, टेल मी प्लीज जमींदारी सिस्टम. गुरनूर, कल आपका माइक नहीं चला था, आई होप आज आपका माइक चल जाएगा. आज भी मैंने म्यूट कर दिया है, यू आर म्यूटेड, बट आज भी मुझे लग रहा है माइक नहीं चल रहा. बट गुरनूर, इफ यू आर राइटिंग आंसर्स इन द चैट बॉक्स, आई थिंक यू कैन स्पीक आउट ऑल्सो. हर्षिता, काइंडली एक्सप्लेन द जमींदारी सिस्टम. हर्षिता, यस.
जमींदारी सिस्टम, आल्सो नोन एज लैंड सेटलमेंट सिस्टम, under this system, the zamindar's main aim was to collect the profit. They were exploiting the cultivators.
They were taking the fixed revenue from zamindars, and zamindars were ultimately exploiting the farmers. That was happening. That what it was in the zamindari system, that the Britishers were taking up the fixed revenue from the zamindars, and ultimately zamindars were exploiting the other farmers. Zamindars were exploiting the other farmers. That was going on in the situation, which was called to be the zamindari system. And that zamindari system made a lot of conflicts between the tenants and landlords. Tenants means the poor farmers who are working on the land, and landlords means the zamindars. The zamindars were taking up, were exploiting continuously the farmers. The farmer was actually working on as a tenant on the farming land, and he was giving the complete production to the owner of the land, that is zamindar. And zamindar was ultimately, in return for the working of the farmer, zamindar was giving a very small amount of production only to the farmer. And even the zamindars that time were not, you know, taking care of the land also. That was a situation which became a biggest problem in Indian agriculture, because farmers were feeling demotivated again and again, and they did not want to work on the farmland under the zamindars. So government had to take some actions. Government ko action to lena hi padta fir. That's why in 1950, when the planning started, in the very first plan, we introduced the planning for agriculture, that we should definitely do something for the agriculture. Hame agriculture ke liye kuch karna chahiye. That's why we are studying now, that what were the problems, what are the importance of agriculture, and why we should do something for the agriculture. And in the next slide, we will study that what government did for the agriculture. I hope I'm clear till now. So this topic we did yesterday, importance of agriculture, right? Importance of agriculture. We all know that agriculture is highly important, and these all points we had covered yesterday in last class, that what are the importance of agriculture. So I'm not taking that once again, because I think you have studied it in last chapter also, because of course agriculture is the backbone of Indian economy. It gives a lot of share in national income, and I told you that almost more than 75% people, working population, is working in the agriculture field. So it is the basically the part of employment generation also, and agriculture only becomes the base for the industrial unit, for the industrial development, because if I want that industry should be developed, then agriculture must be developed first. Then importance in household consumption, it helps in importance in household consumption, it helps in foreign trade. That all we have covered. So moving further. See, this is the very important aspect of this period, 1950 to 1990. Because this slide is telling us that what measures regarding agriculture have been taken by the government. See, we had a lot of problems in Indian agriculture, and we divided those problems into three categories: general problems, institutional problems, technical problems. Again, I'm telling you, general problems, institutional problems, and technical problems. Now, if I talk about that, what measures government took, to improvise the state of Indian agriculture, then in that case, I will be dividing it into three categories. The very first category, I will say that government introduced land reforms. Government introduced land reforms, which are called here, as you can see, institutional reforms. institutional reforms or land reforms. The second major government opt is technical reforms, which is also known as Green Revolution. And the third reform the government did was general reforms. First of all, you must know the meaning of reforms. Reforms. Reforms means new changes, new policies, new plans. किसी पुराने सिस्टम को खत्म करना, किसी पुराने सिस्टम को खत्म करना and to amend that, which means making amendments in some old systems, in some old plans and policies, are known as reforms. So government did agrarian reforms. Government took serious steps in agrarian reforms. देखो point wise पढ़ोगे you will never forget this. Agrarian reforms means amendments in agriculture, changes in agriculture. So government did three major changes. Government did three major changes. The first change government did was institutional reforms. Government did institutional reforms. Institutional reforms means government ultimately changed a lot in the institutions. We will study that what were the land reforms or institution reforms. Like under institution or land reforms, what government did, we will study. Secondly, government did technical reforms. Technical reforms means technology-wise. What government did technology-wise? We will study that in Green Revolution or technological reforms, technical reforms. And thirdly, we will study general reforms, in general changes. What were the general changes taken by the government? All right. So first of all, now we are doing institutional reforms or land reforms. That what government did in land reforms. See, it's here on your screen. Land reforms. पहले ध्यान रखना है हमने government did serious steps to change the agricultural policies in the period 1950 to 1990, which was known as agrarian reforms. Heading ho gayi, agrarian reforms means amendments in agriculture, policies taken for agriculture, changes in agriculture. That agrarian reforms came under for three major parts: land reforms, Green Revolution, general reforms. We simply say institutional reforms or land reforms, which are related to land, land area se related kuch changes kiye gaye. Second, technical reforms or Green Revolution, which are related to the techniques or technologies, jin pe technologies se related kuch changes kiye gaye. And third, green general reforms. General reforms means jisme kuch general aspects ko formulate kiya gaya. So let's study about land reforms first. That what were the measures taken under land reforms? Land reforms ke andar government ne kya measures liye? Very first point, abolition of intermediaries. And very important point also, abolition of intermediaries. You know, Indian government took various steps to abolish intermediaries. And it took various steps to make tillers the owners of land. Jitne bhi ye intermediaries hote the, unko remove karne ki koshish ki government ne, so that the tillers or the actual workers of the farmland should be the owners of the land. Government ne kya kiya? Government ne jo beech mein intermediaries the, government removed all the intermediaries. That means iska direct meaning nikal ke aaya. Government removed zamindari system, right? When we are saying abolition of intermediaries, we are simply saying government removed zamindari system. So there was abolition of zamindari system done by the government as a major step in land reform, that the one who is working on the land now would be the owner only. There would not be any tenancy period. There would not be any system like tenant system. where you can appoint the tenant for your working on the land. Otherwise, there would be some penalties which we'll be studying further. So ultimately, in the first land reform, what government did? Government abolished intermediary's role. Government abolished zamindari system, right? Because if there would not be any zamindari system, definitely there would not be any intermediary which is being involved there in the farmland activity, right? So that was basically done by the government. Next, the next point you can see is tenancy reforms. Government took some tenancy reforms also. Tenancy reforms means government ne kya kiya? Government put some tenancy reforms in such a way that if suppose in any case, if any worker is working, you know, under some zamindar, in any case, if he is working under some zamindar, using his zamindar's land area for the cultivation, in that case, what government did is government regulated the tenant, the rent. The government regulated the rent. कि इससे ज्यादा मैक्सिमम रेंट नहीं होना चाहिए यानी कि गवर्नमेंट ने रेंट सीलिंग कर दिया दैट शुड बी द मैक्सिमम रेंट इसके ऊपर कोई भी जमींदार कैन नॉट टेक रेंट फ्रॉम द फार्मर्स हु आर वर्किंग इन द फील्ड सो दैट वाज आल्सो वन ऑफ द सीरियस एंड कंसर्न्ड स्टेप फॉर द फार्मर्स टेकन बाय द गवर्नमेंट अंडर द लैंड रिफॉर्म्स दैट देयर इज रेगुलेशन ऑफ रेंट दैट शुड बी द मैक्सिमम रेंट which is being taken by the zamindar from the farmers. Likewise, government took one more step. Government did land sealing. Land sealing means government made a regulation that only this much can be the land which can be purchased by one zamindar. लैंड सीलिंग की मैक्सिमम कितनी लैंड कितनी जमीन एक जमींदार के पास होनी चाहिए अगर उसके पास उससे ज्यादा है तो गवर्नमेंट वॉज टेकिंग दैट लैंड सीजिंग दैट लैंड फॉरफिटिंग दैट लैंड फ्रॉम द जमींदार एंड वॉज गिविंग दोज लैंड्स टू द लैंडलेस वर्कर्स टू हेल्प देम ऑल राइट आई होप आई एम क्लियर Now less than 1 minute is left. I think the class may get end any time. So we'll continue the topic in detail tomorrow. Till then, kindly revise this topic again and again. And I'll be giving the assignment today or tomorrow. We'll be uploading on ERP also. So kindly do that in the notebook. All right.